So, what is the key to blessing? As I read in this passage, the key that I see to entering the promised land, to having an abundant life, is to love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, and mind, and to serve him with everything that you have within you. And there's more. We need to be vigilant. We need to realize that every day is a battle. Every day is a choice. We can either live a blessing or live a life of cursing. How do we live a life of blessing? Well, this passage says to have wholehearted devotion to the Lord God and to talk about it wherever you are, with your children when you rise up, when you're walking in the way. And what a beautiful picture that is for us homeschooling mothers, as I am, is learning doesn't just take place in the classroom. Learning takes place everywhere, both for myself and my son as I teach him. That is a beautiful reminder. And also it says to put signposts around you. And one of the ways that I remind myself to live in blessing and not in curses is to have praise music going more than I have, like, say, talk shows, which I do like to listen to because it's an adult voice in the room. So that is a very simple way, is to surround yourself with praise songs. Because life is a daily battle. We can either dwell on our problems or we can dwell on the blessings that God has given us. Every day, every moment is a choice. Jesus said, when he was asked, what's the greatest commandment? To love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, and mind. But Paul, in Romans, talks about how he wants to do good, but there is bad within him. So we have this capacity to turn away from God. We can choose the road of blessing, which leads to abundance, or we can choose the road of cursing, which leads to destruction. So which road will I choose today? Which road will you choose today? Well, I want to choose to love the Lord my God with all my heart and to serve him with everything that I have in me. And one of these ways, again, like I said, instead of focusing on the problems, which I have many right now, I like to focus on, or I need to focus on, God and his power. And one of the ways I do that is to praise him. Sometimes at night, sometimes I can't sleep. And so what I do is I think from A to Z, how can I praise God? His attributes. Well, he is Alpha and Omega. He is beautiful. He is caring. And I think of those things and I meditate. And before I know it, I'm asleep and the problems are totally his. And I'm not thinking about them anymore. That is one tool that I use to walk on this road of blessing rather than curses. So, how do you think that you can live in the blessing, go on the road of blessing rather than the road of curses? Think about that and pray about it, and you will find as you walk in this road of blessings that you will be walking toward that promised land, toward the abundant life that God has given you. Now let's pray. Heavenly Father, I just thank you and praise you again for your abundant life that you give to us, that you long to give to each of us. And I pray that you would help us to love you and to serve you with all our heart, soul, and mind. And that we would choose to walk on this road of blessing. And that you would help us to be aware every moment of the battle that's going around us, that we could choose your blessing, your abundance, rather than curses and destruction. And it's in your precious name that I pray. Amen. Well, thank you for joining me in this Bless Not Stress devotional. And I'm going to leave you with a blessing from Numbers. It's one of my favorite blessings. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace.